At the wargaming table, troops in contact, course of action, and reaction. Troops in contact are TIC, a small unit combat action design, been kicking around, experimenting with, and some recent ideas. Made me think that I just might have made something of a design breakthrough, but we'll see. Time will tell. First of all, the not sequence of play, but course of action. Course of action, meaning instead of a sequence of play implying a structured series of related but still distinct steps or phases. I want to experiment with course of play. The implication being more of a continuously flowing, pattern of actions. Okay, and then now I'm thinking that the situation will indicate the first player and second player. So this is a change. I was thinking about the situation attacker and the situation defender. Now I'm thinking just the situation first player and the situation second player. And distinct, I think, is that when play starts, when play starts, the first player, as given in the situation, takes the first action or activation, and then the second player, and they alternate. Except that when you go to the, when you end the current action period and you move on to the next action period, the following action period, you keep the alternating pattern going. In other words, if the first player was last in the first action period, when you start the second action period, it's the second player who goes first. So the idea is a strict alternating play. No player ever automatically gets a double activation. There is no predictable or set player acting first in each action period. Part of the reason being, and this is not the only reason, but part of the reason is that each action period is exactly like every other one, at least fundamentally. And so it shouldn't matter whatsoever which player goes first. Okay. Another reason, which I won't go into here, but is I don't think that the, traditional, maybe it's mainstream or maybe it's both traditional and mainstream, concept of initiative, which is real. Initiative is real, but I don't think that initiative applies at this scale and scope in the way that I think some war games portray it. And so I'd rather just ditch initiative entirely. The concept is, do you have initiative? Who knows? Who knows? What player has initiative? It's not clear. And frankly, it's not relevant. But that's another discussion. I probably should have a separate discussion just on initiative. But I don't think it's initiative that applies to a battle scope game. I don't think applies to a combat action, small unit combat action scope game. Okay. So ditch initiative. There's a first player and a second player. It's given by the situation. And from then on, it is a strict alternating pattern of, I guess, opportunity to act or activate units. They're still passing, though. I'm trying to think. They're still passing. I think that they're still passing. Okay. We'll just say there is passing. Okay. We'll just say there is passing. I'll have to see that in practice. Okay. So that's that. So let's just say this is our situation. Blue 4 is the first player. Red 4 is the second player. So there's alternating activations. An activation is an activation means one or more units in the same hex conduct actions together. I was thinking about this the other day. I think I am going to, and this is not, I'll talk about gameism in a minute. I think that so if the blue four player, say the blue four player has two fire teams stacked together back here. Okay, that. When blue four player activates this stack, and blue four player can activate any number of these units stacked together, can activate just one of them or both of them together. It's a force. Okay, so one or more units activating together is maybe a force. The force conducts the same actions, paying the same action points. So when they move 1, 2, 3, and then maybe they're done, or maybe they go 1, 2, 3, and then they go down to down posture for 4. Okay, they're done. They are marked with, and this is just notional. Okay, they're marked with, or they are marked +4 AP, +4 action periods like that. Let's just say notionally that is the marker indicating 4 action periods in the future, so to speak. So they are marked +4 AP action periods. Okay. Action periods. Okay. They're supposed to be down. So they act together doing the same thing. If you want them to be doing separate things, those will be separate activations. Okay. Then that's not a gameism. I did a lot of thinking about that, and I think when you're talking about 15-second action periods, when you have soldiers doing things kind of at the same time, or I should say when you have soldiers doing things together under kind of the same order or direction, it just makes sense that they're going to be doing the same thing. You can do different things with different units, obviously, but that's going to break up your activations. Okay. In my mind, it has to do primarily with the time scale here. 15 seconds to an action period. Okay. So they would go there. By the way, they moved in the open. They got down. They would not take any readiness penalty. Penalty is too hard of a word. They would not be... Their readiness would not decrease. Readiness is still 100%. Okay. All right. Now, then it goes to the red 4 player. Let's just say red 4 player passes. Comes back to blue 4 player. Now, this is going to incorporate the new idea. When blue 4 player activates this unit, and the unit goes up to to up posture, zero. I wonder if, no, zero, no, no, that's, you know, I just realized, and I'm going to say it now, going up posture, I still believe costs zero action points, but I think going up is an action that can be reacted against. So in other words, if there was not a T-80, but if there was a fire team here and they observed the Blue 4 team going from down posture to up posture, I think that they could react to it. So I need to remember that it's not just the expenditure of action points. It's actually, so I guess there are zero action point actions that still can be reacted against. Okay, put him back. All right, so Blue 4 fire team goes to the up posture, zero. They go one, and I'm gonna say two. Yes, okay, so to review, yes, the fire team entered the woods and still paid one action point. Now, for the fire team to move into a clear hex and declare one means that they are moving at a slow to slow moderate pace, keeping their security, keeping their fields of vision overlapping, keeping their fields of fire overlapping. They're basically in good formation, if you want to use that term, which I think is fine, although saying good formation, unfortunately, maybe for some war gamers makes them think of older warfare, but no, it's still good formation. But when the Blue 4 player moves the unit into the woods and says one, that means that the fire team continued moving at that pace, and when they moved into the woods, they lost some readiness. Okay, so the player will look at the table, a table. So the table will say, if you move into a clear hex and you expend one action point, there's no readiness cost. When the unit moves into the woods, the Blue 4 player looks at the table. This is a table I haven't developed yet, but I'm thinking about it. So the table says you cross-reference woods with one action point. And that means that the unit did lose a little bit, let's say 20%, let's say readiness. You're going to put a marker on top. The marker on top, well, it's going on top because it is very, very temporary. But so when it moves into there, it picks up. I'm going to try to do this in order, right? The Blue 4 player has to compute the loss of readiness and mark it, because that happens after the unit has moved into the hex. So, okay, what does 20% loss of readiness mean? What it means is when the fire team moved into the woods, they did not slow down to keep their good formation. So that means that as they move among the tree trunks and the branches, etc., they're losing a little bit of formation cohesion. We're saying 20%. That's what that means. It just means fields of fire are getting less, you know, there's less nice overlap. There's less ability to maintain eye contact, et cetera, et cetera. Now, what we're saying is if the Blue 4 player does not want to take this penalty, the Blue 4 player can say two as it moves into the woods and say two. When the Blue 4 player moves in there and says two, well, I guess it would be three, right? One, two, three. The Blue 4 player is saying that the fire team slowed down to maintain its good formation. And then you'd look on the table and you'd cross-reference woods with two action points, and you would see, maybe this is just an example off the top of my head, you would look and you'd say no loss of readiness. So it would not be marked with loss of readiness, and you could maintain your security basically, which of course is probably what you would do. But let's start with the example of moving more quickly through the woods. Of course, if you're, no, let's not do that. Let's not, that's what would happen if you did that. Let's say the blue four player knows that this fire team is the lead, and so you shouldn't, you can be reckless and move like that, like we just talked about, take a readiness, blah, 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 but you're not going to do that. You're going to say, you know what, I have the opportunity to be more, maintain security better, right? So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Okay. At this time, red four player may interrupt the action and react. Okay. What does that mean? And of course, red four player doesn't have to do that, but let's just say red four player is going to do that. So red four, and by the way, this is the decision. Red four player can say, do I react now or do I wait until it's my activation again and then act? So I guess it's players alternate actions, reactions, or no. Players alternate activations, and an activation may be an action or a reaction. Maybe that's the way to put it. So if red four player interrupts blue four's activation to activate this fire team, it is a reaction. Okay. So what would happen then is, first thing, the blue four player would go ahead and mark plus three action periods. 1, 2, 3. and then red four player, now red four player is going to, okay, red four player can interrupt any blue four action that is observed. So actually, and by the way, I was thinking about this, there isn't going to be any gamey situation of saying that you have to guess whether you can observe or not. No, red four player can say, halt, let me see if I can observe this. And this is going to be important because the rules still have pretty complicated observation rules, and so you'd be checking for the formation and the movement and the distance and the posture of the observer and all that stuff to determine whether this red four fire team in down posture in the woods observing 100 meters across an opening or open terrain into a wood line, seeing a fire team moving at, the expenditure of action points in that hex. Maybe I go to that level. Anyways, I wasn't thinking about that. Okay, so red four player can say, halt, let me see if I can observe this. Red four player determines after going through the calculations, yes, he can observe. So now, red four player is going to react. Now, this is what is different. Before, I had like initiative switches to the red four player, and he basically starts acting with that unit that he's reacting with. No, it's going to be different now. It's going to be different. What it is, okay, let me see. Okay, what I'm thinking now is that the red four unit observes the blue four unit expend two action points in that hex. And I'm thinking that the unit that's reacting gets two action points to basically react with. And that means that, does that work? What I was thinking was that means that the red four player could pull back for two action points. Basically move for up to two action points, or it can fire. So now let's say that if red four player is going to fire, Then we go through the whole thing, right? So in order, the blue 4 unit is forced to down posture, goes to full cover, and then red 4 player determine, you know, goes through the calculations and let's say determines that it's 8. Can't remember what I was calling this, but 8 casualty factors. Boom. And then the red 4 player's unit is still marked with the same action period marker as the target. Boom. And what that means is that, that means that blue 4 unit moved through the opening before the red side reacted, then it moved into the wood line, at which point red 4 started reacting, and then this all happened. And then that is red 4's action. And it goes back to blue 4. Which I'm keeping this, by the way. I'm keeping, if you react, that is your activation. So it is alternating activations. And for an activation, a unit is either reacting if it interrupted the opponent, or it's acting. Okay. So if red 4 player is not going to fire, still interrupts, which obviously doesn't force blue 4 to down posture or anything. If red 4 gets 2 action points, because that's what it observed blue 4 player. Okay, so if red 4 player gets the same number of action points, then they might they could go up for 0 and move. Oh yeah, they would move quickly back like 1-2, and they would lose readiness, having moved quickly through the woods. Then marked with the same period marker as the unit it observed. So I'm wondering, does that work? Why doesn't it work? Why doesn't it work? I think it does work. The only other option is that the unit that's reacting always gets to expend 1 action point or fire, which is 1 action. See, what this means is, I think, I'll get to this again. So these 4 red 4 soldiers are in the wood line. They're watching 4 blue 4 soldiers very slowly, not very slowly, because there can even be slower than what they're doing, but Oh, can there be slower? Maybe there can't be slower. All right, they're slowly moving into the wood line there. And what I'm thinking is if the red four player is going to react to this, then they're very slowly and very carefully, but not all at the same time. They're kind of one by one up, moving. I mean, the piece moves as a unit. What I'm getting at is the piece moves as a unit, but it didn't move. In reality, it didn't actually move as a full unit. They didn't all get up and move. I'm saying they fell back. Yeah, I think what's involved here is there's falling back, pausing, taking a knee behind a tree trunk, maintaining security, observing what's happening over here, if possible. I mean, soldiers over here could be observing what's happening, and then they fall back. And this is all happening in pieces as this is happening, as they're slowly moving into the wood line. So actually, I guess that does work. Now, the idea that works, but now I'm wondering what happens if red four player observes blue four player expending two action points in the wood line there. It interrupts. He's going to react. Can they, let's say, go to up posture and like charge into the open? They could even go up for zero, one half, one. One and a half. That doesn't really make any sense. That doesn't really make any sense, but why? No, it doesn't make any sense. So what? What to do about that? See, I'm wondering is, okay, how would it work? Okay, red four player here. Okay, let's just experiment. What would happen if red four player interrupts, says I'm reacting, has two action points to expend, goes up for zero. And let's say they actually go one half. That means that they're running into the open there towards the blue four fire team that they're reacting to. Now I'm wondering if. If. See, if red four player didn't fire on blue. Then maybe blue four player gets to fire on red now. But how would you? Oh, I know what. Well, it's a constant interruption, actually. So how would that work? That would go if red four player really did that. And we say, well, now blue four player, although they were interrupted. They're moving in slowly. They quickly get up, quickly dash into the open. Why wouldn't blue four just open up? If we say blue four unit that yes is already marked with an action point, well, I'm sorry, an action period marker, if we say they can open up fire. So, all right, let's say they did that. Red 4 player still gets the same action point marker, action period marker from the original interruption. Red 4 player is forced down, forced to full cover, and let's say, let's say it's 10 casualty factors like that. That's from Blue 4's fire. Then what? So Blue 4 had something it could react to, except that they were already marked. Oh. Unless we say, I didn't want to go here. I did not want to go here, but maybe a unit, even though it's marked with an action period marker, can always return fire. I didn't want to go there, but maybe that is a way to do this. If Red 4 player they fired there. All right. I guess I back to the drawing board. I know I want to have interruptions. Just how to do the interruptions, can you have interrupting back and forth, right? In this case, Blue 4 acted. Red 4 interrupted. Does the movement undertaken by Red 4 itself, is that itself allowed to be interrupted? And can it be interrupted by the same unit that was already interrupted, right? So act, interrupt, react. Can this reaction be interrupted by the same, can it be interrupted by a unit that is already marked with an action period marker? Maybe I should put it that way. Can a reaction be interrupted by a unit that is already marked with an action period marker? That is a question. You know what? I'm going to leave it there. There's actually another something that I was thinking about. This is a completely different idea, completely separate idea. I was thinking this. I was thinking, what, say like that, all right, so if Blue 4 goes 1, 2, 3, this Red 4 unit opens fire. We go through the whole thing. he gets marked with a plus 3 action period marker. Then when we say, if we say 1, 2, 3, then, well, basically the question is, can red 4 open up fire if, in effect, at this point, the blue 4 unit is marked with the same, see, it's marked with the same action period marker as this fire. What I was trying to avoid is saying that this unit just gets to keep firing at everything that moves, basically. I'm trying to avoid that. So right now I'm saying, if this unit, well, basically I'm saying, because this red 4 unit is already marked plus 3 action period, then it cannot actually not fire at this unit. So then we'll say he goes down posture for 0. However, if this unit now goes 1, 2, meaning that he's moving much faster, so in effect, he actually moved out ahead of this unit, That unit moved 1 and then 2, 3, so it slowed down moving into the forest. This unit moved quickly, 1, 2, so actually this unit arrived before this unit. Actually, this unit arrived before this unit or this unit, right? But now I'm thinking that if he goes 1, 2, and you look at the red 4 unit, the red 4 unit doesn't have a plus 2 marker under it. Now I'm thinking that if this unit is marked with, let's say, a plus 2, right, a plus 2 action period marker, and red 4 is going to fire on him, by the way. So he's forced down, he's forced to full cover, and you drop, you know, whatever the casualty factors are, boom. Okay. Then, this is what's different. Now I'm thinking that the red 4 team is now marked with the same action, plus 2 action period marker. So yeah, he's marked with and actually the player would keep them in order, right? So the plus 2, plus 3 action period marker on the bottom, plus 2 action period marker, and then like that. And now let's just say for illustration purposes, let's say that this unit over here moved, 1. Actually, of course I'm supposed to, actually I should show it. That unit should be marked with loss of some organization there, which actually, let me explain, actually go back to this. When that unit moved 1, 2, he would have been marked with that. And now I'm thinking because he goes, I'm trying to think, I don't think it would stay. Off the top of my head, I think when red 4 opened up fire and that unit was forced down, right? Forced, I mean, technically he walks in, blue 4 team walks in into the woods, takes a minus 20% readiness cut penalty reduction. Red 4 player fires, it's forced down, and it goes to full cover. Yes, it's still there. I think that is factored into the whole, well, as a matter of fact, let's say that it would be more than the other one there. Let's just say, right? So the penalty, I think, is computed now, right? Right, and because it's computed now, I think this goes away, and here's why. Because after, so it drops like that, later when the whole thing is resolved, the team has already, out of necessity, come back together because, well, it's a discussion for another time, but I think that is what happens. So I think that comes off. So here we have the same thing. So now what I'm saying is this unit goes one, red four unit interrupts, which that's what I still have to resolve, right? I don't think I've resolved that. I don't think I've resolved how that works, but it gets marked plus one like that. Again, that's figured into his firing, the whole firing thing, forced to down, forced to full cover, and then we say, you know, whatever the casualty factor is, whatever it is. Boom, that goes away because it was factored into there. Now the red four unit gets the same marker, but this is a plus one marker. So again, he puts them in order like that. Okay, this is the idea. Yes, the unit has three action period markers stacked, but this shouldn't happen very often. It can happen, and if it can happen, I want a procedure, but it shouldn't happen too often. So what happens is each action period, you're taking these off in succession. All right, I'm wrapping up this video. But that means that he's really limited to three attacks, and he's limited to one attack in plus one action period, a second attack in plus two action period, and a third attack in plus three action periods, for example, in this example. But he doesn't get an artificial double, triple, quadruple attack all in the same action period. That is one idea for how to proceed with this. I think I'm going to do that. I do think I'm going to do that. But the question is still, if he was already marked, well, I guess you just look and you say, well, he had a target that was first, actually. So this guy came first. He actually saw him first. Then he saw this top unit moving quickly into the wood line. Then he saw this one and the one underneath enter the wood line at the same time. Huh. Something like that might actually work.